some grapes.
Ooh.
Wanna go wine tasting right now?
I don't think we have time for that. We are in the boonies.
I don't know how well everyone's gonna find this place.
Just yeah, because. It may just be you and me at this wedding. So, I mean, like, you've been kind of weird since you got home last night.
Yeah. Going into our wedding weekend, it was supposed to be the happiest day of our lives, and with what happened at the bachelor party, I'm really f***ed off of Mike. He's trying to persuade me to like someone smaller, and I think if I told Joy, she would not want Mike anywhere near our wedding.
What happened at the bachelor party? I know, like, it was kind of a mystery, like, you weren't sure what was going to happen.
You know, it was... I mean, Mike kind of messed up. So, you know, I told Mike, no strippers, like, anything like
right.
that. We got to the bar, and Mike kind of was cool because he, like, found a place with a plus-size burlesque dancer, and I was like, oh, that's kind of cool.
Yeah.
And then the strippers came out.
Like strippers?
Like strippers, like dancing on the bar. And like, it was almost like they were like targeted towards me. I wasn't gonna tell you. I was gonna just.
Okay. So like Mike is the reason that we have secrets now? Mike tricked you, did a gross thing to you. Like all of that's messed up. It is upsetting thing to hear about. Mike's pretty selfish and immature. I do hope that Chris stands up to Mike and establishes some boundaries. Yeah, I've been like worried about having Mike at the wedding. I'm not gonna lie. I'm like,
Mike's like my friend. I don't want like.
Should Mike be your friend though?
That's messed up.
I mean, is it though? Because I don't know. Honestly, yeah, I don't even know like why he's coming.
I'm on my last straw with Mike, but it's hard because I love the guy, I care about him. You know, I don't want to lose my friend. It's a tough pill to swallow.
Oh, I set up the chairs and everything.
Yeah, the chairs look great.
Watch your step on this gravel when we're coming down.
I know, it's like super nice. Looking at the ceremony area, it's just absolutely like lush and beautiful, and there's trees everywhere. There's a staircase on the side. I guess I always assumed that I would walk through the middle of a space, so it's to the side. It doesn't have a handrail. Okay, well, I don't know, do you want to try the steps?
I don't know. So this is where I would be standing if
yeah.
you did that, where I came up to give you a hand.
We've talked about me meeting Joy at the top of the stairs to kind of help her down. Kind of strange, but I don't mind doing it if you want to do it.
Yeah. Being heavy, I, of course, have some physical challenges. I do, of course, have a slight fear that I'm just gonna eat it.
Thank you, kind sir.
The steps are inconsistent levels. Some of them are a lot deeper than others. Some of them are almost like two steps. It's not gonna be my most graceful entrance, I don't think. And I'm also going to have trouble seeing my feet in this big dress. So I'm a little bit worried. I feel like, it's gonna, they're like big steps and they're gonna be big even if I don't have someone holding my hand.
I think just take your time, a count.
Yeah.
Because you want to come down slow, right?
Sure.
I would think.
Look at me.
Yeah, you can do a pose every step.
Yes.
Like you could even pause like at each step just for a dramatic effect. So this is a big one. So if we had to, we could put someone here just to come up and like.
Joy sometimes struggles with stairs, and these ones have a lot deeper drop, and she's gonna be in a dress, and thank God she's not in heels. So to be honest, you know, it's kind of strange to have the groom walk the bride down the aisle, but if that's gonna make Joy comfortable, then I have no problem doing it. Well, I mean, honestly, like, I have no problem standing up in the grass.
Mm-hmm.
I don't mind it. It's our wedding.
Right.
It doesn't bother me at all to be up there, but whatever you want to do.
And I don't know how helpful it would be either, honestly. I just don't know how helpful Chris would be. Ultimately, having his arm there isn't actually that helpful. I just hope that I don't trip. Goodness. Okay.
I'm gonna swap this out.
Okay.
Our wedding's kind of really laid back, so we thought it'd be a good idea just to have simple barbecue for rehearsal dinner.
A lot of y'all travel from very far away, and it like means so much to me that y'all were able to come.
Wouldn't miss
We've got like Arkansas, Tennessee, Virginia, Nevada, Colorado.
How are you guys feeling about tomorrow?
I mean, like, I'm really excited.
Yeah. I'm a little nervous. I've been like working on the vows. I gotta like write them out.
Gotcha.
Joy, do you mind if I do a toast real quick?
No, I would love that.
Okay. So I just wanted to say congratulations to Joy and Chris. You guys make love all happy and gooey and inspiring. So congratulations, and I'm super excited about tomorrow. And cheers to Joy and Chris.
Thanks, Tiffany. Cheers.
Can I say something real quick too?
Oh.
So. Man, I don't even know what to say.
Yeah, I think Mike feels the pressure to give a speech because Tiffany made one.
When I met Chris, we were both single, lonely apprentices. And years later, he's getting married and he's my boss. So at least one of us is grown up. Joy, keep his leash a little loose, please.
It's pretty annoying to have Mike here. I don't really feel like he contributes a whole lot to our dynamics. I feel like he sort of sucks all the air out of the room.
The night is still young and we got a lot of food and drinks, and I think we should have a good night.
Yeah, let's do it.
Wander. All right.
Sounds good.
I can see Chris distancing himself from me because of the marriage. And it would suck to lose him because I do see him as a brother.
What up, man?
What's up, Mike?
Not much. Chilling.
Kicking up by the fire?
Yeah.
Oh. Something I've been on the fence about is, do I just part ways with Mike? I mean, I care about the guy, but now I'm starting to question, like, if he's doing this kind of stuff before I'm married, is he gonna do it after I'm married? I can't believe I'm getting married tomorrow.
Can't believe you're getting married either. So I haven't really talked since San Francisco, man. Is it all good or what?
I don't know, man. Like, it was kind of messed up. Like, the whole time, like I told you, like, you know, I don't want like strippers there.
Every bachelor party has strippers, man. Come on.
Yeah, but I mean, I'm like not the, I don't know. I'm just not the typical bachelor, I guess. And I don't like skinny, thin women. I'd like specifically told you. And then you like go and get thin strippers. It just leaves a bad taste in Joy's mouth. What is your problem with Joy? Is it that she is fat?
I mean, she never comes out. The only time I ever really see her is when I come over to your house.
Yeah.
Like, we go to Tahoe, we do all these fun things together, and she never comes. Like, what's up with that?
It's just, she doesn't have fun doing that kind of stuff, you know?
They may talk about backpacking across Europe together or go climbing mountains, but she goes out of breath just climbing down these stairs. How can she go backpacking across Europe or do anything like that? Now, like, I'm just afraid that you're gonna slow down and not come do fun things that we always do.
You know, she's gonna be my wife, and if I have to choose like a wife over a friend, like I'll have to make that decision.
See, I knew this would happen, man.
Obviously, like I don't want to.
You know, I guess we'll see what happens.
I've known Mike for a long time, but if he pulls another stunt like the bachelor party again here at my wedding, we're gonna be done.